It was the strongest tornado outbreak in Mississippi since 1966, and it carved a path of terror through Smithville.
Yeah, the small town of just over 900 residents emerged on April 27th to find 127 homes and 14 businesses destroyed. And as sports director Christian Stackel tells us, an unlikely group of young athletes made a decision to begin the healing process.
This is
it,
Wren, tornado behind us.
I basically thought that it could be a hard time and just try to get the safety.
We're going to
turn the TV on and actually see it coming. It's just adrenaline gets going and you look for cover.
I looked at the radar on my computer and it was just totally red. I walked out after it was over with and basically the first thing I saw was the gymnasium just gone. And I walked on down and saw the football field gone, baseball field gone. I don't have words to describe the destruction.
The Smithville tornado left a deadly trail of carnage. Peak winds were estimated at 205 miles per hour. The twister's path stretched almost 4 miles long and up to a half mile wide.
It's pretty much a horror story, really. Just seeing the town and the destruction that the storm left is just unreal. It's hard to even think about.
Two-thirds of Smithville is absolutely gone. I mean, it's just not there anymore. And I can't describe it. You know, words don't do that.
Sometimes the measure of a team can't be found in the box score, such is the case here with the Smithville Seminoles. Just 4 days after an EF5 tornado ripped through the heart of this town, they decided to take the diamond and compete in the postseason in the loving memory of 16 who were killed here in their hometown.
It was not by any means, hey, we've got to go play. I think it was a chance, an opportunity to gain that normalcy back, to get away from it, you know, for a little bit.
It was a home game, but we weren't at home. You know, we were at a neighbor's field. We had our PA announcer. He had a script written up giving thanks to everybody and we just had to relive it all over again just listening to him talk. I mean, it was a tearjerker day that day.
It felt good just to play ball again and just get my mind off what happened to Smithville.
Personally, I didn't lose anything, but a bunch of my friends did. And so you think about them. That's who you're playing for, too.
Some stories have a Hollywood ending, but most are based in reality. Smithville was eliminated from the second round of the playoffs by Greenville St. Joseph. The Seminoles won't hang a championship banner this year, nor wear a ring to symbolize a title. Instead, they'll be remembered for something far greater, inspiring a town that was leveled to the ground with hope when seemingly there was no place to look and find any.
We got guts, I think. The boys have guts. They gritted their teeth and went after it.
When times are at their worst, it's sometimes when people step up and they're at their best.
Thank you for all the help that everybody sent to us. It's really appreciated.
We'll rebuild and hopefully be stronger than we were.
Just gives you chills.
Yeah, wow.
Wow, inspiring. Well, the people of Smithville still desperately need your help tonight. To donate to the American Red Cross, please call 1-800-RED-CROSS.
And to make a $10 donation to the Salvation Army, text GIVE, G-I-V-E, to 80888 or call 1-800-SAL-ARMY. And you can also donate online. We do have a link to their websites on ours, WAPT.com.